Welcome back, and this is part 4 of my video tutorial series on Azgaar's Fantasy Map Generator. In this part, I aim to cover miscellaneous details not included in my previous videos, most notably, the style menu. On top of this tutorial and tips, I highly recommend joining the Discord, Reddit, and Patreon if you have any of those media. Azgaar works hard on an essentially free project, and showing your support will only help improve the tool. So let's hop right into the style menu. I've already gone over the default presets, so I will be delving into the style elements themselves. Most menus feature about the same options, an opacity option to make the element transparent, element color, width of the element, and a filter. One of the first things I do with a new map is to go into Style Editor and make the states have a higher opacity. This way, their color is a lot more emphasized and brighter, which is what I personally like in maps. Overall, Style Editor is all about finding what works for you, and it is what makes maps on this generator truly unique from one another. I also find filters to be the most impactful feature, as they affect the element in more unique ways than simply coloring and making translucent. For example, if we look at biomes, Blur 1 actually looks pretty good and nicely blends the borders between biomes, while Blur 10 is probably too extreme. The most unique functions, apart from those I mentioned before, can be found in a few selected features. As I covered in a previous video, relief icons can be changed drastically in terms of detail and coloring. Heightmap also has a few unique color presets, as well as the terracing option. You can change the terracing via these next four options here, and add a bit of unique texture to your map. Moving on, the font of anything with words on it, like labels, can be changed as well. The ocean style also comes with some patterns, which change the ocean background. You can also replace the ocean background entirely by the texture option. Make sure it's enabled under the Layers menu. Under Styles and Textures, you can set a high-res background picture, like so. A vast majority of these style menus contain repeated features which you've already seen. In an effort to keep this video concise, I believe I have covered a lot of the more standout aspects to consider. Next is Zones. Zones operate like provinces, states, etc., but are used to designate a kind of event. It is up to your own imagination on this, but often these zones represent things like the spread of diseases, contested territory, or literally anything not already represented on the map. All you need to do is add a zone, name it, and select a color or texture. Note that zones are selectively added and deleted, as well as can be layered. For example, having contested highlighted paints this zone, but then clicking this erase button only erases this same selected zone. Next up, we have markers. Markers are icons placed to represent a particular location. Because burgs already represent cities and towns, markers can represent locations like battlefields, volcanoes, or mines. You simply need to select marker from the add menu and click anywhere you desire. Remember, you can shift-click for multiple markers at once. The marker automatically scales to your screen unless you go into Style Editor for markers and select Keep Initial Size on Zoom Change. This option prevents markers from remaining small if you zoom in and then add them. When editing a marker, you can designate its type, icon, size, shape, and colors. Markers essentially represent location to add notes to, which you can edit via this first button here. With markers out of the way, now onto options, which I have yet to cover fully. As you probably already know, the options menu inherently interacts with everything else in the background. Here, you can set the canvas size by pixels, and it should be automatically set to fill your browser window according to your monitor size. Under this is seed. The seed only works for generated maps and will not save the changes to height map you make after generation. Here is also where you set your world name, the current year, and the age it takes place in, such as AD or BC, but something special, obviously, to your own fantasy world. The name of your map will save with it whenever you save a .map file. Additionally, the years are considered for a variety of different aspects, not all of which are apparent. You can most prominently find the years being noted when militaries are generated and battle markers are introduced. Next is the map template for when you randomly generate it. This affects nothing else other than random generation with new map. The cultures number, states number, provinces ratio per state, towns number, and religions number can all be set and then edited manually, as I have covered throughout this series. Cultures can be limited by culture set, but this has no bearing on manually adding cultures. For example, if you want to have historical European cultures, but then wanted to add one elf culture, that will never be restricted. Size variety is the differences in sizes between one state and another. A high value means more variety, and a lower value will see all states generally the same size. Growth rates determine how many lands will stay uninhabited. Often the generator expands from coasts and then goes inwards. So mountains are the last places often to be inhabited if you go with a high growth rate. Everything below generator settings affects the user interface only, except for emblem shape, strangely, which does pertain to the map itself. I think these are mostly self-explanatory, but ask in the comments if you have any issue. The last aspect in this video I'd like to cover is the external assets you can find through the GitHub page. Notably, Cartography Assets and Goteguru's Submap tool are community contributions to this program. You can view maps and namebases which are pre-made and ready to import into the generator via the Cartography Assets page. Goteguru's Submap tool is capable of creating an entirely new map just out of a piece of your overall map in the Fantasy Map Generator. I have not used this tool yet extensively, but I personally plan to in the future, and I encourage you to try it out as well. There are further community initiatives and collaborations happening in both the subreddit and the Discord. All links will be included in the description below, and that will be all for today. Thanks for watching.